गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज देवेंद्र नायक एंड आई एम इंग्लिश टीचर क्लास सिक्स। सो इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर वन क्लास सिक्स ग्रामर द सेंटेंस। ओके, द सेंटेंस so what is a sentence? I am writing some group of words here. Sister, my teacher is here. Will come tomorrow. Was waiting. I was for the. Okay. So there are three groups of words. Sister, my teacher is he. The second one, will come tomorrow, he. The third one, was waiting, I was for the. So what do you observe in these three groups of words? The first group of words, sister, my teacher is he. So this group of words, does it give us any sense? No. So the group of words does not give us a complete sense. Similarly, in the second group of words, will come tomorrow, he is also not giving a complete sense. Similarly, in the third group of words, was waiting, I was for the, is also not giving us a complete sense. So according to the definition of a sentence, we cannot say all the three groups of words are sentences. So how can we make it a sentence? This group of words, how can we change them into sentences? So what we have to do first, we need to do the correct order of the words in the word groups. Okay, so let us do sister, my teacher is. The correct order of the words are my sister is a teacher. Okay, my sister is a teacher. Does it give us a complete sense? Yes, of course it is giving us a complete sense, because the words in the group of words are in correct order now. Okay, that is why we are getting a complete sense from the group of words. Okay, my sister is a teacher. Similarly, in the second group of words, we can rearrange them into their correct forms. So it will become, he will come tomorrow. Now this group of words giving us a complete sense, he will come tomorrow. Similarly, group of words, we can rearrange them in their correct order. So I was waiting for a for the bus. For the bus. Okay. So the three group of words now became sentences. Okay, because they give us a complete sentence, a complete sense. Okay. So what do we learn now? We learn that a sentence is a group of words that gives us a complete sense. Okay, so a sentence is a group of words that gives us a complete sense. And remember, a sentence must have start with a capital letter and it will end with a proper punctuation mark, like full stop, question mark, mark of exclamation. Okay. So students, we know that what is a sentence. So these three groups of words are sentences. I am a student, the plant is full of flowers, people often commit mistakes. Okay, so what did you learn? A sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. It's called a sentence. And also it begins with a capital letter and it ends with a proper punctuation mark. So here in the first sentence, I is the subject and there will be a verb in a sentence. So in the first sentence, I is the subject and am is the verb, and it makes a complete sense. Therefore, we can say it is a sentence. Similarly, in the second one, the plant here is the subject. What is the verb here? The verb is, and it also starts with a capital letter and ends with a punctuation mark, that is full stop. Okay. Similarly, in the third sentence, people often commit mistakes. So here, people is the subject and mistake and commit mistakes, and commit is the verb. Mistakes nahi. Okay. So let us learn what is a phrase. What is a phrase? The phrase. I am writing a sentence here. The tree is full of flowers. Okay. So in this, it is a sentence. We know that there is a subject, there is also a verb, and the group of words also make complete sense. So the tree is full of flowers is also a sentence. So how can we find out the phrase here? Okay, so here we omit the subject, and when we omit the subject, there is this part only in the sentence. This part is full of flowers. Okay. Does it give any complete sense? No, it does not give any complete sense. So we cannot say it is a sentence. So it's full of flowers. With then omit the verb is. Then what is the remaining parts of the sentence? Full of flowers. So full of flowers is also a group of words, and it also giving us some sense. Full of flowers. So it is a phrase here. Okay. I'm writing another. Have two boys there. Their house is these are also three groups of words. Okay, have two boys there, house is like full of flowers. This group of words do not give us any sense, at least some sense. So we cannot say this group of words are phrases. Okay, so what do we conclude about a phrase? A phrase is a group of words within a sentence that gives us sense but not complete sense. So what is a phrase? A phrase is a group of words within a sentence, or a phrase is a part of a sentence, and it gives us some sense but not complete sense. Okay. So students, what did we learn about a phrase? So a phrase is a group of words in a sentence, and it makes some sense, not complete sense, and it may or may not have a verb in a phrase, and it does not make complete sense. So how can we use these phrases in a complete sense? So these are the examples of phrases. Okay, because according to the definition of a phrase, on this group of words fulfill the conditions of a phrase. Okay, walking in the rain, joy and sorrows, to watch movies in the dark night. Okay, so let us complete the sentence by using these phrases. Okay, so I am writing the first one. Okay, walking in the rain. So what will be there to make a complete sentence by using this phrase, walking in the rain?
I was
walking in the rain. So we just include the subject and verb part, and then it connect the phrase and it makes a complete sentence. Now we can say it is a sentence because there is a subject, there is a verb, and it also begins with a capital letter and it ends with a punctuation mark, full stop, and it gives us a complete sense. Okay, so similarly you have to do these three group of words or phrases making a sentence. Okay, make three sentences by using the remaining parts of the sentence. Okay, so students, thank you for watching this video, and in your next class we will discuss more about the kinds of sentence. Okay, thank you.